some of Chelsea's young trainees in action for the Blues. They're among hundreds of 16-year-old hopefuls who leave school every year to sign up with Premier League clubs, dreaming of fame and fortune. As apprentices, they'll earn just £37 a week. As stars, they could earn £20,000. The next 2 years will decide if they have the talent and the staying power to make it to the top.
Every single boy who walks through that door thinks he's going to make it. But it's a tough part of their life. They're leaving school at 16 and they're coming into full-time work, into a man's world. Not only man's, but a bloody tough world it is. And for them to make it, you know, there's so many things stacked against them. OK, fellas, here we go. This is it, innit? Just like to welcome you all, first years especially. Great opportunity for you. Don't have any regrets. No regrets, OK? It's a start. Hey? Do it.
The new intake is joining six other trainees who are beginning their second year. Like all their heroes, they start out as boot room boys.
I know it's a pain in the neck, all these duties, but they've got to be done. The gaffer's office. He's the most important geezer at the club. Nanny. It's got to be absolutely spot on. If he leaves on a Saturday evening at 9:30, you then go in and do it. And the same goes for my office, Ainsley. OK? Home team dressing room, Hams and Agri. Jimmy, he's a good worker, Hamsy. Right? That's why I put you with him, because you're crap. We're going to set the standards. Because when you've done them, you come back and see me, Dave or Oz, and say, can you check them? So you set your standards this morning.
I want you to concentrate on your football. And there'll be times when I'll do your job for you, if I've got time.
He's having one, by the way, isn't he?
If I've got time. I know Graham.
Big mistake.
For the second year boys, it's their chance to initiate the novices.
Get doused last year yourself?
I was alright because I was like quiet, I kept myself to myself and just stayed out of it. Most, there was only like a couple who got done, but like Graham put his foot down because a couple of boys got a bit upset over it, so. But it was alright.
You laugh, mate, you watch it, yeah, you watch it.
Over 20 years ago, their coach Graham Ricks was an apprentice himself.
I know what my lads are going through. I know it's a pain in the arse, to be honest, when you're young. And me as their coach, I've said to them already, look, yeah, I'm your coach and I'm your manager, but really I'm your mate and I'll do everything I can to help you. And then they've got no excuses, have they? You can't give lads any excuses.
You can see that,
Graham. Ah, you've got to have vision. You want to play football, you've got to have vision, Quinn. Bit of chewing gum that, I don't know, some away players stuck on the wall, and that would be very expensive for Neil, that would be a black mark. But it's his first day, so we're just going through it. OK, not bad. I'll bet next time I inspect it, there's no chewing gum on the walls. Should check the toilets. How do I get that out?
The wrong way round.
Wrong way round. OK?
Yeah.
I mean, what you've done is you've loaded it up, but the geezer before you, look, feel that. That bit has got to be sticking out the bottom, hasn't it?
Yeah.
That'd be another black mark, Clem. It might seem meaningless tasks, but you have to realise that you've got to be able to rely on your teammate. You know, there's good workers and people not so good. I'm sure Clem will be excellent, because that's his attitude, he wants to do it. But it's his first day, he's just got to see what the standards are here. Hey, Clem.
Yeah.
Horrible bastard, isn't he?
I think I'm going to have a word with Graham, because by the time he does come home, he is so tired. I mean, I think it was the first week he said to me, Mum, he said, I have just cleaned loos. And I said to him, I've been doing that for years. He's had a taste of it. He was using the Hoover at Chelsea the other day.
Hoover in this dressing room for an hour and a half.
The Hoover wasn't picking up the vacuum.
No, I was on my hands and knees for another half an hour.
But the thing is that you ought to practice when you come home.
Clements gets over a good cross.
It's all I've ever wanted to do, because I want to follow in my dad's footsteps. And my dad ended up playing for England, done that five times, and wants to just do me. I just want to be half as good as him, even if I can do that, you know.
Clements got a bit of a thump on him.
Like the odd occasion, say, when I've had a bad day or something, I think, oh, I wish he was here, you know, like, to help me, but he died when I was young, so. But I know he's there somewhere. I know he's around watching. I know he's proud of what's going on, so. That's my dream. Play for my country at like, the top level. But as I say, on the first run of the ladder, there's a long way to go.
Do you mind the duties?
Yeah, but it's got to be done, you know. I don't know what it must have been like in the olden days, you know, when they used to sweep the terraces, and we have it a lot easier, but it's still a pain in the neck, because all you want to do is just play football.
Jim, get your hands out of your ass, Jim. Relax. Relax. Yes, Nanny. Get rid of that beer gut. Nanny's very professional. He's got his watch on and his puffy little band and all that. Sorry? Nanny, where you go? Big lap, Nanny, that is crap. Bye-bye.
You've got a sense of humour in this game where you won't get nowhere. When I first come here, everyone gave me the stick and I was really quiet. I wouldn't say nothing back to them or anything. I suppose it's because I was a bit apprehensive of, you know, since they're older boys than me, you know, they've been there and they had it all before. But, like, after a while, about halfway through my first year, I started to come into it more. I think that was the story for a lot of the first years. You know, they're a bit shy when they first come here. But after a while, you just got to break yourself in, really. It takes a bit of time.
I like it, by the way. They don't know it, but they're going to run for 10 minutes. It's 80 degrees, hard work on the AstroTurf. It's a test for him. Keep going till I tell you to stop.
Last year, I didn't want to fancy going out and training, just wanted to sit in there or whatever. But like nowadays, I just can't wait to get out there and train now. And I had to talk to my dad, to talk to my mum as well, and I promised that I'm going to give it my best this year.
OK, just out to me, nice and easy it is, nice and easy, foot on top of the ball. Little roll with each touch. Just get used to it again. That's got to be your best mate this year. That's got to be your best mate. You can be your best mate or your worst enemy, eh, Mav? It's your best mate, isn't it?
Andy, come here.
Push him in. Don't let him out. Good
Andy, Jody.
You can tell the lads are enthusiastic. The test room will be when they're injured or they're not in the team. If things are going badly for them, that's when the test is.
Surrogate father, as well as coach.
Yeah, you know, I'm the mate. I want to be the mate. And I want them to enjoy the work, because they have enough, excuse the expression, they have enough shit to put up with when they're at the club off other people. So when they're here working with me, I want them to enjoy it. It's not always the case. You know, I'm going to steam into a few of them, obviously, through the season, but and I've got to be the mate and the coach. Probably more importantly, the mate. Because out of that lot, you know, three make it. What about the other 10? They're going to need a mate, so.
I felt it pop, and I just couldn't move it.
Did you see any bruising in your leg?
Yeah.
Where?
The same place. It was like came up purple around there.
And what did you suffer?
Well, I couldn't walk. The leg would only move, you know, a few inches.
Hello, Jimmy.
Every new trainee must have a full medical from the club doctor.
Do you remember exactly when you injured it? How long you were out?
I injured it in December.
Yeah.
And I was out for about 4 months.
Jimmy Agri, like most of the trainees, has already had several major injuries before getting to Chelsea.
When did you get back to full training again?
In about a month and a half's time.
Okay, your ankles?
Ankles, I did injure it about a year ago, but then it was just like swollen for a bit, and the swelling went down, and it was all right since.
Okay, wait there.
Every year, at least one of the boys suffers a serious injury.
For your insurance? They're just signing for the right time.
Their biggest fear is that it could stop their career before it begins. But for now, the closest that some of the boys will get to follow in their hero's footsteps is to clean their boots.
The first couple of weeks is hard, but after about 3 weeks, you just get used to it. And after like a couple of months, it's just like your life, innit? Everyday thing. You know what you've got to do when you come in.
What made you want to do it?
I don't know. Just want to become professional, earn a lot of money. Have all the women and that's it. That's what it's about, really.
You're a dirty dread, man.
Day in, day out, each trainee has to clean up to 10 pairs of boots for the stars and can only dream of what might be.
That's what you can be. When you're a professional footballer, that's
what you want, eh? He's got some butts, I tell you.
The cleaning jobs are all about attitude, and Graham is worried about nannies.
Graham been polished, haven't he? Tell him porkies. You're the overseer, nanny. You're responsible. Look.
Could be done again.
If you had to wear them in a match, would you be happy with him?
No.
There you go.
Nanny is a smashing lad. Last year, just had the odd game, did OK. Came in, did OK. But now he's got to do it week in, week out, be top-notch. We'll see. I like him. But that counts for nothing. I'd rather I hated every single one of them and they all got taken on.
Standards, chaps.
I thought we'd have a nice early lunch.
And that's gone right out of the window, hasn't it? Come on, get them all out, Nanny. I want to see what's at the bottom. Probably Lord Lucan in the bottom. Now that is good, isn't it?
I'm so glad they're filming this. I'm so chuffed. Because you think I'm talking out my arse half the time, but I'm not, am I? Look at that.
Let's just do it properly for feet. As soon as we've done this,
we can go. You fucking teach me on feet time. Wait, I went, it's you. You've been doing it. I was doing the same count.
Not all of them are like that.
You're a stitch.
Is it what you expected?
No, not really. I expected short days. I thought I'd be home like 3 o'clock every day, but really I'm home about 6 or 7, if I'm lucky. It's like, get home, have a few hours, and you've got to go to bed, get up the next day. Got to work on Saturdays. You only really get Sunday off, rest day, and you don't really feel like doing anything because you're just knackered for the morning.
He's played since he was 5, and in his little books at primary school, when What Do You Want To Be? He's always wanted to be a footballer. But he went off the idea a little bit when he was 13 or 14. But he's sort of come back to it a bit now. So I'm not really surprised now. But whether or not it's entirely what he wants to do for the rest of his life, I don't know, time will tell.
Ball there, he plays it in, I'm coming off in a straight line. Go on, Plug, do what you do, Plug. Do what 9 out of 10 centre-halves do when they're in a straight line. Well, I'll do it to you.
A hard taskmaster off the pitch, Graham is no less demanding on it.
Ball played in. Have some of that.
Good manners don't make good footballers.
I'm the centre-forward now. Get on his shoulder, one for him, one for yourself, off at an angle. I might let it run. I might lay it back. But I've worked him. I've got myself maybe 2 foot, maybe a yard. But every little bit of space helps, doesn't it? OK. Be as nice as pie off the pitch. I really mean that. Try and get on with people. Smile, be happy, enjoy your life.
when you cross that line, whether it be for training or a match, you've got to become a bastard. You've got to be a hard, tough bastard. Smile. You can have a smile on your face, but in there and in your heart and your stomach, you've got to be tough as nails. They've all got some ability, else they wouldn't be here anyway. It's how they use that and if they get the best out of it and if they are willing to progress. Some lads are frightened of progressing. Now, hopefully, in the next 18 months, 2 years, I'm going to knock that out of them and they're going to go onto that pitch at Old Trafford in an FA Cup semi-final and show people what they can do.
Hold it! Hold it! Have a breather. Have a little stretch while Nanny's doing his 20 burpees.
Jimmy Agnew. He's been here 2 weeks, Jim, and he's gone from being a confident young man who's starting his job and thinking the world's his oyster to all of a sudden questioning himself so much, thinking, oh, I can't be a footballer, I'll never be a footballer, I can't even trap the ball, I can't. That's because he's in a pressure situation, and it gets worse. It don't get easier, the pressure, it gets worse.
I work from Monday to Friday, and my aim's to get in the team on Saturday. But sometimes when I hear the team and my name's not announced in the team, it just puts a dampener on the whole week. And I think Graham's a brilliant coach, but I don't feel he's got the best out of me.
Ooh, Jim, got those size 14s round it.
It's got a lot of work to do, Jim. It's got to be mentally tougher. I think he talks mentally tough, but I think that's a little bit of bravado. He's a big lad physically, but it's a little boy inside his head.
I'm proud of him, really, for what he achieved. But he's really one to fight on, you know, to be somebody. And that's what he always says, keeps saying. And he's very proud when he sees George Best and other heroes, you know, I mean, he really does worship them. They said he's going to be one of them one day.
But not today. After a poor performance in training, Jimmy is on punishment duty, getting his heroes to sign balls for charity.
Sometimes, like, my confidence goes down, I think. It does affect me a bit, but then you've got to be strong, you've just got to go on. Just go on, yeah. But I'm going to make up for it on tomorrow in training. Hopefully try and get selected for the match on Saturday. Just go for it. Give it my best shot. Yeah. That's it, that's all you can wish for. But it's just to get off the good start. And hopefully one day I should be signed the ball. My signature. That's the aim.
Very rarely does a player go through his career without ever having something happen to him. I'll give you a little example of me, where everything was rosy for me. I was 19 years of age, I was in Arsenal's first team, and we got to an FA Cup final in 1978. And out of 42 league games, I played 38. I scored in the semi-final in the FA Cup. And 2 days before the final, the manager pulled me in and told me I wouldn't be playing, I'd be substitute. For a 19-year-old boy to accept that, after what he'd done that season, I thought my world had ended. Did I cry or did I cry? In front of him, on my way home, in front of my missus. Next year, we got to another cup final, I played. The year after, in another cup final. So I thought, I'm never ever going to get the chance of playing in a cup final again. And I got the chance of playing in two. And I savoured those two.
What an amazing comeback!
To a certain extent, you lose a little bit of your childhood because you have to be disciplined. You've seen something you want and you've got to go for it.
For Graham and his protégés, the first big test of the season is against the Arsenal apprentices at Highbury. The fight for places is intense. It's already led to a punch-up between two of the most promising new trainees, Jody Morris and Neil Clement.
On the pitch argument, it's boiled over.
He was on my team in training and he had a go at me and just had to go back and started pushing each other and then she threw a punch at me and I threw him back. It's just one of those things, you know, it happens, isn't it? Best mate as well. Yeah, we are. Best mates, but it happens, isn't it? Maybe.
If you ain't motivated playing on a pitch like this, in a stadium like this, there's two ways of looking at it. Can be too much for you, or you can say, this is why I'm playing football, because I want to play in stadiums like this, only with 40,000 in it. Week in, week out. That's why you're playing. So accept it. It ain't just another game, is it? It's a special game. It's a special game. Don't waste it. Shouldn't need a team talk.
Inspired by Graham's words, his young charges rise to the occasion on his old stamping ground.
Come on, Ainsley, you've got to make it, Ainsley! You've got to make it, Ainsley!
Jimmy and others on the bench can only sit and watch as the team triumphs without them.
To me, come!
Stand up, Clem! Stand up!
Concentrate, come on!
Not a bad ball, by the way.
Come on, lift it, Blues! Lift it!
Well done, man. Well done,
Graham. Well done, cheers, Pat. Well done.
A 3-1 victory for Chelsea, and things are looking good. But as the season continues, the pressure on the boys to succeed will take its toll.
On to the next one.
Yeah, Ainsley's.
Ainsley, hiding them away in the corner.
Insurance, these
are. Ainsley, are they yours?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
What are you doing? You're hiding them underneath there, thinking Graham will look underneath
there. They've been there for a long time. I ain't cleaned up the boots. I don't put the boots underneath there. I don't clean the boots.
Are they your boots?
Yeah.
Are they your match boots?
Yeah.
If they're in the boot room, they've got to be ready for matches, Ainsley. All right, yeah. Are they yours, Joe?
I think so.
You think so?
Well, a schoolboy wore them.
Joe's trying to make a career out of football and he doesn't know if they're his boots or not.
A schoolboy wore them and he told me he cleaned them, but...
You know what I mean? I shouldn't be having to do this. If the chaps really wanted to do it, really wanted to make football, their boots would be spot on. Neil Clement, where's your boots? Yeah. Show me them, bring them here. I get the impression Clem wants it. It's got shoe bits in and everything, they're immaculate, look. One brownie point, Clem. Your standards.
Yeah, you're right.
I'm right, Anna.
Yeah.
That's what you got performing, isn't it? Yeah. On a Saturday. Slice it into touch and things.
Always happens to me. People stitch me up, wear my boots and don't tell me and all things like that, you know what I mean? Scandalous. Isn't it, Joe?
You're good enough to let a schoolboy use them. Get hold of that schoolboy and say, where's my boots? I want to see him. Yeah. And Ainsley, look, he's laughing his head off there, Ainsley, look. Turn round, Ains. Turn round, come on. Are you?
They don't really like their duties. As long as they're showing a good attitude and putting all their efforts outside, I'm prepared to be lenient with them. When they... When they're not showing the attitude and the effort outside, then sort of get them to work to rule. More time doing menial jobs.
A lack of effort, both on and off the pitch, brings an early end to the dreams of 3 second-year trainees. One of them is Ainsley Ulla.
Ainsley in particular had problems from the start with discipline. He and the others have had to go. I don't think they'll make a career out of football. If I'm perfectly honest, again, I hope they prove me wrong, but the application and dedication that we're on about earlier, I'm not sure they had it. And if kids aren't up to it, hard as it is, hard bastard that I am, that's how it's got to be done.
Not easy.
I know I'll make it somewhere if I don't make it here. I'm good enough to make it here. I know I'll make it somewhere else. Take a step down, maybe go to another lower division. Then sooner or later, I'll be up in the top division again anyway. It doesn't really bother me that much.
The boys still dreaming of a professional contract soon have the chance to prove themselves to Graham. Their test, a European under 19 tournament in northern Spain. For some of the trainees, just 16, it's their first time abroad.
This tour is for lads who we feel have got a chance going all the way, who are hopefully going to play in Chelsea's first team in European competition. And it's to give them experience of different cultures, different tactics, and to put up with a lot of rubbish and being able to discipline themselves over any given amount of time. 4 games in 4 days is a test.
The Blues' first game on the Spanish-French border is against hotly tipped Osasuna.
Nice surface, pass the ball around. But remember why we're passing it around. We want to win the game. Keep them out one end, knock them in the other.
Pass it! Oh, oh, fuck it! Fuck it!
Richie! Why? The free kick! Fucking walk away from it!
What, stay cool?
He's having to give it to them. He's fucking done, isn't he?
Rules you play to it.
Hey ref.
After a string of brutal fouls against them, Chelsea are beginning to lose their cool and their faith in the referee. This slap from centre forward Mark Nichols earns him a red card and puts him out of the next game.
I don't believe this.
It was sitting
here. He is the worst fucking referee I've ever seen in my life.
Down to 10 men, and tempers are boiling over. Fullback Neil Hans rages at the referee and is sent off. Down to 9 men, Graham's boys tough it out.
Stick together.
Let's put straight on the next job in
hand. A nil-nil draw. It's now down to penalties.
We ain't taking them for fun.
Well done, guys. Different class.
Excellent. Proud.
Excellent.
Stay cool. Excellent. Well played the team and
well
referee.
Well played, Brody. Different class.
Come up to take your penalty. Stay cool and slot it.
Concentrate. Right. Want to score.
Now, we've got a point from our first league game, unbeaten, so we need to score as many as we can, OK? It's important. It's not a Mickey Mouse thing. It's not to entertain the crowd.
Could mean us getting through the
final.
Could
mean us playing Monday or not, OK? So it's important.
Osasuna's 5th penalty, a chance for Nani to cover himself in glory. To draw level, the decisive penalty falls to captain Richie Hanlon.
thinking process. That's why you're out here. Huh? That's why you're out here. I'm proud of you all. You fucking not only did you battle against them and a scandalous referee, you were down to 9 men, 10 men. Should have won the game. They had the best chances. Nanny, have a shot to save.
So managed.
It's just as well, because you didn't save a pen, did you? Little gentleman. Nicole should have scored. Joe Richardson should have scored. Amzie, I'm telling you to stay cool all the time. You're shouting at the referee after he's booked you. You deserve to get sent off, Neil. You can't do those sort of things. It's games like that, and it's tough and it's tight and everything's against you. We've got to play them at the wrong game. Second half, when we started getting at them, ripping them open left, right and centre. A little bit more belief in yourself, chaps. OK, you see what it's like, that's your taste. Go on from here, eh? Win the next two games. Because we can do it. On to the next one. You're still in it.
Oh, yeah. The Iceman coming.
No.
Your root magazine's away.
Root magazine.
With many of the team nursing injuries from Chelsea's Iberian campaign, Ted Dale, Graham's assistant and team physio, visits the walking wounded.
Did you get any pain from it at all? Lay over on your back, sorry.
The first casualty to be treated is Richie Hanlon.
That's hurt. That hurts, is it?
That's it.
Pain? No? Maybe it's just a kick.
What do you think of the game, Rich?
My game first. I did all right. The penalty was crap. I was actually going to put it in the other corner. I changed it at the last minute. I missed, obviously.
Stop.
See you later.
Some of the boys are nursing regrets as well as bruises.
I knew what to expect, the diving and, like, spitting on you and elbowing you and all that, but it was worse. I got what I thought was an unfortunate yellow card. I miss the game tomorrow. This time of the year as well, is when I'm up for contracts, things like that, they never go for you. A lot of the time you're thinking, if I don't get it, then I don't think I could carry on. I was sick of the game, but it's an addiction, isn't it? I just love the game so much. At the times, it gets to you really badly, like getting in early mornings, cleaning boots.
Yeah, I should be in bed. The train going freezing cold, yeah. December, November.
Cleaning boots.
You cut through your hands and that, and then go out and run your bollocks off for like an hour and a half or whatever, and you think, what am I doing this for? I could just walk off the train and go home and forget about it.
But once you get out there, like, your troubles just fade. And I love it. Love the game. God knows what I'd do if I don't get it.
Hamsy, Neil Hams, smashing kid. Nervous wreck. Absolute nervous wreck. And it does me in to, you know, see kids in that sort of state. I suppose they've looked on the trip as my last chance. If I go there and play out of my skin, I might just sneak it.
On, Jimmy!
The next match, and Jimmy Agri's back in the team for a game in the Basque Country that the Blues must win.
On your toes! Organise!
The two players sent off are not allowed to play. But Graham believes that the squad's ability and his tactics will give them a good chance of winning through.
Well done, big man, unlucky.
But 5 minutes into the game, things start to go wrong.
Come on then, today, Nanny!
Despite their goal, the Blues are 2-1 down at half-time and Graham shows them a new face.
Do we want to fucking win this game or what? Do we want to win the game? Because I get the impression there's about six or seven out there who don't fucking want to win it. We're falling into the old trap here. They've come out, nice, yeah, playing football. Nice referee, and we're going, oh, it's a friendly game. It ain't a fucking friendly game. You got to liven yourself up, Kev. Get tuned in, OK? Jay Richardson, get fucking tuned in. You understand me? And if nothing else, you run your bollocks off. If it ain't happening for you with the ball, you run your covers off.
Hang on, sorry, Greg, just bear this in mind. The team yesterday kicked shit out of you, OK? You lose this game, you're saying to them, go on, you go in the final. Because if they get a result today, they'll go in the final. Do you want them to get in the final? Crap team like that? We've got to get to tomorrow afternoon, something to play for. Not going to play Real Madrid tomorrow in a meaningless fucking 70 minutes. You can't give yourself that test unless you do something about this one.
It's not fucking tactics or anything like that, it's application. Can't afford to let another goal in. Can we? Nanny, you always want Nanny, don't you? You always want. We need a result, guys. You understand me?
Keep concentrating!
As the second half begins, Chelsea push for an early equaliser.
They go, Nick Brendan!
Unlucky!
But after a near miss, the effect of Graham's pep talk wears off, and the Spanish side go 3-1 up. Outplayed by an older and stronger team, tempers start to fray once more. Graham can only stand and watch his team fall apart.
Come on!
Two more Spanish goals follow.
And you just organize!
But there is more to come.
You want to play? Come on! And push them back!
Defend properly!
Come on! Safe.
With Graham's boys facing their biggest ever defeat, frustration gives way to anger. For that tackle, captain Richie Hanlon is sent off and out of the tournament.
I know you've got to set an example, but it was so frustrating. You've just got to stop them getting through somehow. So my frustration out on the player. That's the first time I've ever been sent off for Chelsea. And the last out. That probably will be the last game.
You're fucking captain of Chelsea Football Club and you're doing that. You're supposed to lead by example. What you did was a disgrace. Absolute disgrace. That isn't showing me you're bothered, that's showing me you're stupid. I've learned that being nice and being soft here, get a kick in the bollocks. I knew it wasn't going to be easy, chaps, this tournament. I knew that. But the least I thought I'd get from you is a little bit of spunk, a little bit of spirit. Anybody gets beat. But to get beat, giving the impression you don't give a toss, that's really hurt me. So many heads dropped.
Ice. Anyone else need ice? Ice doesn't mend a broken heart, by
the way. Hi, Mum!
Richie's a smashing kid. Rather immature, if I might say that. I was disappointed in his reaction yesterday to his sending off. And went to the back of the bus to tell him so. He's been leery, trying to take the piss out of people. And I just went back to the bus and said, if I'd have acted how you had this afternoon, I'd have been sat in a corner, deep in thought, really thinking about what I'd done and the consequences. He's got half a chance of getting a year's contract. He doesn't know that. When he sees this film, if he uses this piece, then he might say, God, why didn't I react differently?
Unable to drown their sorrows, the lads are balking at Graham's strict regime.
It's boring. This whole trip's not boring. Yeah, there's nothing to do at the hotel, no swimming pool, no gym, no nothing. You know? Just sit in your room all the time playing cards. Just gets boring after a while. Even a change of clothes would be quite a good time, huh? Tracksuit, isn't it? So you're in. Coming away to Spain, not getting not allowed to go out your hotel or anything like that. It's just tedious. But the manager says goes, but I just think it gets everyone down, though.
I think you know me well enough. I don't rule them with a rod of iron. I said to them after the first game, well done, you're not going out tonight, but you can have a beer in the bar. I meant a beer in the bar. But we've got a game tomorrow. That's what we're out here for, not to drink beer and have a giggle and take the piss. We're out here to play football and learn from that. And obviously some people's priorities have got mixed up a little bit.
Next opponents, Real Madrid. But despite Graham's attempt to lift them, team morale has plummeted, and they're already thinking of other things.
Do you reckon we should have a chaps night out? Next Saturday? Yeah, next Saturday? It's your birthday, innit? Go out. Buzz bar.
I'll shut up.
Joe's house for a party.
I reckon we're
going to
do well,
innit? You are. I reckon, right, someone will get sent off against Real Madrid if we're losing 8-0. I reckon we'll get hammered by Real Madrid about 20-0. Oh, fuck off.
With no chance of making the final, the game against Real Madrid is the team's last chance to prove themselves to Graham and to restore their pride. By half time, they're 3-0 down. But shortly after the second half begins, the scoreline goes from bad to worse. Poor performances, drastic measures. Midfield player Jimmy Agri suffers the indignity of being replaced by the reserve goalkeeper.
For Jody Morris when he would knock that ball in the net. I was delighted for him. Because the way he's performed the last three games, he fucking deserved that goal. And you're all going to say, oh yeah, but he's your favourite, Graham. He ain't my favourite. But I see in him somebody who can not only play, but wants to fucking play. I want people who, A, won't let me down, or him, but B, want to have a bit of pride in themselves to be the best. Not go along with the crowd, sit at the back of the coach and have a little giggle. Want to be the fucking best. You have got to have a serious look at yourself in the summer, you. Because you think I've hammered you this year. You haven't seen it, mate. I could have played out there today and run about more than you. That's embarrassing. I was watching you once for 20 seconds and they had the ball and made 15 passes, and you have not moved. You were still in the centre circle, and we're 5-1 down. Catch you on your foot, flick it on your neck, means bollocks to me. You got replaced by a goalie. A goalie. You bothered? Bothers me, but indirectly, it doesn't really affect me. Because I'll be here. Or somewhere. because I've got a bit of bollocks and a bit of passion. I have. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe the old psychological approach, let the chaps make the decisions how badly they want it. There's a few of you need to really analyse how badly you want to be a top-class footballer. Ken. Jake. How badly? You're young lads. How badly do you really want it? The chance of doing something that you love and getting 10 grand a week for doing it. 20 grand if you're really good. Nah, I'll have a beer. I'll have a fucking laugh with the chaps. When you're a superstar, do what you want. Within reason. Do what you want. When you're a 38-year-old has-been like me, do what I want. Drink, smoke. But until you've done something in the game, don't let anything get in your way. I want people who want to be footballers. If you don't want to be a footballer, don't come. If there's anything higher in your life than football, go away now. I feel let down by a few chaps.
By midwinter, two of the first-year boys, Neil Clement and Jody Morris, have surged ahead of the others. They're now training regularly with the first team, and they're about to be given what they've always dreamt of, their first professional contract, much to the delight of their parents.
Was I training this morning?
Training on that, yeah.
That's true.
He said they was going to be doing it in the gym today.
Yeah, but they're the big boys, isn't he?
Have you let him wear bottoms then?
Nah.
Let him go out in shorts in this weather.
Help what?
Is it for more money this time?
Hey, who brought you in? We like to go out again. No, it's less this time,
oh,
Pat.
No,
you don't trust me, do you?
No,
you don't.
Trust anybody.
Chelsea's managing director, Colin Hutchinson, is there to grant them a 3-year contract.
Well done, young man.
Thank you.
Where are we going to go on the first month's money?
Will
it take more money?
Shopping, yeah.
Yes. And then a meal out somewhere.
Yeah, whatever.
Yes, that'll do. It'll be nice to go down to the ground on a Saturday, have my seat.
Mm,
a cup
yeah.
of tea, half time.
You can get down the terraces with everyone else.
I don't think so. Got to be extra selfish now,
yes.
And focused.
Your first professional contract.
So
it's the first of many. Well done.
Cheers, thank you.
Keep working hard and who knows, might be in the first team before too long.
Can you renegotiate after 500 first team appearances?
I think so, yeah.
Hope so.
Phone has to stop ringing. Got a telly message there for you, Joe. I think it's from earlier.
We're all talking about it, like, you know. Even his little sister. She's at home with chicken pox at the moment, but, you know. Oh, I want your brother's autograph, you know, this and that.
They're yeah, but you go to school sometimes, people are saying, oh, yeah, Jody Morris's little sister. See if she can get his autograph for us.
That's nice. There must be a lot of boys out there very envious. But he's done it all on his own back. He's the one who's put in all the years, year in, year out, work. You know, running out in the snow and everything else, so...
Dream come true.
All that bit now and then.
Yesterday, YTS trainees on £37 a week. Today, professionals on £1,000 a month. Jody and Clem are determined to look the part.
I don't know where they get these pictures of me from.
think my mum and dad were really worried about that, me, because all my mates were doing drugs and thieving, and I mean, there was a good enough crowd, good at heart, but they had nothing else. They was just going to school for a laugh. If I'd have stayed behind, then who knows what could have happened. I've seen my mates do it. My mates have been good footballers, and they've just gone the wrong way. So who knows what could have happened to me.
They are 16. They're just starting out. And then all of a sudden they're in this environment where they have got the chance to go out and have a good time. I have tried to steer him in the right direction. That, you know, you can't go clubbing and then go training the next day, because you will not be able to do what you're supposed to be there for, and there will always be another boy that will do it. So, you know, you've got to be prepared, because you're looking over your shoulder the whole time, right the way through your career. Because if you do get injured, there's the young player behind you wanting to take your place. Happens all the time.
It's a high five for Chelsea at Stamford Bridge. Chelsea are going to take this opportunity to bring on 17-year-old Jody Morris in place of John Spencer. Morris, who was a ball boy here, brought up close to the ground, been playing superbly well in Chelsea's reserve team. Well, Jody Morris getting his chance, I'm sure, much earlier than he expected. Bella, beautifully laid off to Morris. Welcome to the Premiership.
It was a shock, really. I remember the gaffer just said, "You're going on, son, go and get warmed up." My belly started going, didn't it? So I was running up and down the line, and I remember standing there warming up. All the fans were shouting, "Jody! Jody, like behind me in the crowd, and I'm thinking, all right. But they was all shouting. I thought, like, what are you all shouting at? Because I was stretching, watching the game. I've looked behind, and there's about 10 of them going, pointing to the bench. I looked down to the bench, and I could see the gaffer going, "Come here, come here, come on, son, do you want to get on?" And he just said to me, "Go out there and enjoy it. You're good enough. That's why you're going out there. You're going to show them what you can do." My mum was scared to come and watch me as it was. "No, don't put him on. Don't put him on near big men out there." She was really scared for me, but that's how all mums are, isn't it? But I remember thinking when I was going on, "Oh God, like, what am I going to do when the ball comes?" sort of thing. But after I had my first touch, "All right, give me the ball now. I just wanted the ball."
The fact he's involved with the first team is showing those lads what he can do. And they've responded to him, to be fair. You know, they trust him, pass it to him. They're all delighted for him. He's been here 6 months. Brilliant.
Pleased for Jody getting in the first team. A bit jealous, but pleased for him. Excellent player. Stoyer's obviously, he struggles a bit, but he's a good player, great touch, gets him out of trouble a lot of the time. Even though he's a short ass.
Yeah, this, of course, is envy, jealousy. You know, when you see him come in and they've got all new boots and things and all that.
Almighty, this, almighty.
You still have to do all the duties, even though you've now got a contract.
Yeah. It's good, really, I suppose, in a way. Even though you wouldn't mind it just to stop tomorrow.
When do you stop doing the duties?
At the end of the 2 year YTS. Well, what it would have been.
While Jody dreams of stardom, the three remaining second year boys await their fate. Today is decision day.
Did you get much sleep last night, then?
Yeah, I did eventually. Took a long time, though, to drop off. Just kept thinking about everything and that. So nervous, I suppose. And it's like 2 years can be just gone like that since I'm saying no. It's a very big day for me.
Are you cacking your pants?
I am. Are you?
Yeah.
The hardest bit for me is just going home and telling my mum and dad. That's good.
Hey, mum.
I told her that we're going to get in touch. That's going to be the hardest bit, telling them.
All I told is my missus, and I told my mum and dad.
Then go.
I want to get told, but...
Oh, come on, just fucking tell us.
Yeah, Danny? Best son.
While Neil Hams and Richie Hanlon wait their turn, goalkeeper Nanny Sexton is first in to see Graham.
It's just over.
Don't really matter.
Don't make me sweat.
It's all over in 2 minutes.
And you know that. Fucking neck's killing me. It's gone stiff again.
Come on, just give it him. Just give it him.
For Nanny, the dream is over. There will be no professional contract.
Did you say you've got it?
No, just wait.
Shit, man.
Neil Hams is also told by Graham that his future lies elsewhere.
To the right.
It's been a difficult 2 months, really. I've been with those kids for 3 years, really, as schoolboys and YTS boys. So, yeah, it's... most important 2 years of their lives has passed them by and they hadn't really got what they wanted.
Following his performance in Spain, Richie Hanlon is turned away too.
When they're good kids and they've tried really hard, it's difficult. No matter how bad or how good a player they are, it's difficult to tell them. You're one-on-one and the kids' eyes are filling up. And they've got to go home and tell their parents. That's the tough bit, isn't it? Being rejected.
The thing that pisses you off the most is, like, you see other people who've got pro and they're shit. I couldn't be bothered to get another club, do you know what I mean? It's too much hassle.
So I'm thinking,
I don't think that's shit. There's 92 league clubs. Don't tell me there's not one club, there's not one that don't want you. Exactly. That's just... that defeats all laws of averages, mate.
That is impossible.
Notice that you've come on... this beef, look at it this way, right? Look, take the positive, really. You've come here for 2 years, mate. This getting right, Graham Hicks is a fucking outstanding coach, isn't he? And you've become a better player. Now, surely you can take that onto another club and say, look, I'm a good player.
There's so many people who've been rejected at 18, 19 and gone on to become superstars. It's a dream. You have to aim for the top, don't work out. Little notch lower, don't work out, little notch lower. Sometimes you find that kids have to go down to come back up. Some kids go down and never recover.
Remember our faces, what it's like. That's your chance.
I might go out tomorrow night and sit to my birthday, do you fancy? Just get under the neck.
What the best big man over here?
It's the best thing to get you down,
mate. Yeah, you can pay. It's
a case of us. It's destiny.
It's been a pleasure, son.
big day here for Jody Morris, taking his first place amongst Chelsea's starting lineup under the watchful eyes of new management Ruud Gullit and Graham Riggs. It's an opportunity here for him to show his skills in front of a host of international stars. It's Wise, throw to Petrescu, to Viali, Hughes, Jody Morris going in! What a story that could have been. He was nicely set up by the more experienced players, and he has to think to himself, it really could have been some night.
I've had the little taste. I want more now. I want to play for England, be the best, you know. Captain England, do everything you can in the game. Be a manager after, I want to do a lot, you know. And if I don't, then it's not down to anyone else. It's down to me.
It's the greatest job in the world. Greatest job in the world. Well paid for doing something you love. You work down a pit, you come out and you play on a Saturday afternoon and you pay subs, you pay 30 bob, £1.50 to play. You work in a bank, you pay £1.50 on a Sunday to play with me, mate. And here you've got a chance of playing in the stadiums like this, packed out with 40, 50,000 people every week, being paid fortunes for doing something you love. That's a dream, isn't it? That is a dream. Wish you were 16.
Of the three second years who failed to make it at Chelsea, Richie Hanlon has a one-year contract at Southend United. Neil Hams is now unemployed and sometimes plays for non-league Leatherhead. Nanny Sexton has given up football completely and is an apprentice air conditioning engineer at Heathrow Airport. Jimmy Agri is still at the club and hoping to prove his worth. Neil Clement has played for England under-18s, as well as playing regularly for the reserves. And Jody Morris proves that dreams can come true.
And this time he has finished very crisply indeed, and Chelsea are level.
Oh, that's a glorious goal. And he really did finish so comfortably. Young, young lad. This is more like it. This is what I think we'll see tonight. He's the target man. Lovely run off the ball from Morris, created his own space.
Scoring his first ever goal to bring his team level tonight. And he's proving the man that Blackpool can't contain at the moment, Jody Morris. Not too many nights like this in his career.
Next Tuesday at the same time, the true story of an election campaign in a Sydney suburb full of dirty tricks and double dealing. Coming up next tonight, trauma,